Greetings, friends. Sonic Toast here. We're going to call this Talesy Tuesday. Yeah, I know it's usually Turtly Tuesday, but it can be two things. Anyway, we're going to look at the 5-inch movie Tails figure. Wow, look how happy he looks. He is happy about this, and so am I. Let's read his character description here. It says, Tails is Sonic's best bud. Using his brains, tons of gadgets, and of course, his two tails, he will do everything he can for his friends. Very cool. I already gotta say, this is such an improvement over the movie 2 Tails figure. But and then, of course, we got the other three figures in the wave right there, Sonic, Shadow, and Ivo Robotnik. Can't wait to unbox him. And so that is that. Let's go ahead and get Tails out of the box and see what he's like. Toast. All right, now here is Tails out of the box. And just like the 2.5-inch Sonic and Knuckles figures, I feel like they had so much more to work with this Tails figure. And he is such a huge improvement from the Sonic 2 movie figure that we got a couple years ago. But still, this thing just looks fantastic. I love his eyes. He too, just like Sonic and Shadow, has those eyes that can kind of follow you because they're all glossy with the lens over them and everything. And he seems to have a lot of articulation. He actually has 20 points of articulation, so 2 less than Sonic and Shadow. So when it comes to articulation, let's take a quick look as his head turns. It is a ball joint, so he can kind of nod and everything. So that is pretty good. I wish he can go side to side a little more, but still, good stuff there. He does have the butterfly joint in the chest. He has the shoulder joint. He has the elbow joint, double jointed elbow, very cool. He does twist and bend at the wrist, and he has the fingers that move, and then he has legs and knees. Looks like it's a single jointed knee, not double, and then he has the same foot joint as Sonic and Shadow. Right there, that goes, that pivots and bends, right? And then he also has his tails, which they can turn together as a unit, but then each individual tail also has a joint there, which can make it go up and down and turn left and right and everything. So that is pretty dang interesting. This might be our first ever Tails figure to have 2 separate tails. You know, usually they're you know, just sculpted together as one unit. So that is, that is super interesting. We did mention how he only has a single jointed knee, unlike Sonic and Shadow. He also is missing the twist at the thigh. He has no twist at the waist, and he has no twist at the bicep. So I think those are all the articulation that he does not have that the other figures do. Now, one thing about his tails is they are solid and they are heavy. So you can use them to keep the figure, you know, balanced and standing up. But if you want them to be up in the air, there is no way you are gonna get him to stand up. Even with one tail on the ground, the other one is still so heavy that it is not gonna work. You gotta put both tails on the ground. And because you can control his fingers, he can hold whatever you want him to hold, such as this, the map from the second movie. He can hold the Miles Electric, or he could hold a bag of Cheetos, a Ren and Stimpy action figure, a cat sandwich, pretty much anything. And here is Tails next to Tails, the 4-inch Tails from Sonic Movie 2. We can see a huge, vast improvement in the new one, of course. I mean, the face on the old one is quite goofy. I think he's based off the artwork of him, like, you know, you see it in like the mobile games from the Sonic Dash and Sonic Speed Battle and stuff. Look how his eyes are like literally bulging out. It's kind of wacky there. Whereas the eyes on the new one look so good with the whole, like, you see how his eyes follow you as he turns? That's great. Now, Jax has already outdone themselves with their Ultimate Modern Tails action figure. Like, I don't think this movie Tails is nearly as good as this Ultimate Tails, but it is still a quality figure for $15, while the Ultimate Tails was like $50 at retail. So still totally worth it. Now here is the Tails Superposer, which I am convinced is like the best Superposer they ever did. He looks incredible, he doesn't fall down ever, and his articulation is just top notch. Like, from his giant hand, his fingers move and everything. Oh wait, I was mistaken, he actually has tails that move independently of each other. So this was the first one to do that. So yeah, there are a lot of great Tails figures out there, and this new movie 3 Tails figure is good, but it is definitely not the best Tails. I think this one is, this Superposer is definitely a candidate for best Tails ever. Although the collector's edition Tails from Jack's Pacific. That's also definitely a candidate. And then we have Jax's 5-inch figure of Tails 9 here from Sonic Prime. And this too is a very well-made, super well-articulated figure. I mean, 70 points of articulation. I don't think there'll ever be another Tails toy that can match that, or even a Sonic character, a Sonic figure at all that can match 70 points of articulation. I mean, are there any other action figures that have that much articulation? I mean, that is nuts. Here he is with the 5-inch movie Sonic figure, and I just love it when they get Sonic and Tails' proportions correct. They look perfect together, just the right height. The style is so perfect. Yeah, I love it. So friends, overall, this is just shaping up to be a really great line of figures. I think Shadow is still the best one so far, and then Sonic, and then Tails is in third, but that's not saying there's anything wrong with Tails. Still a really good figure. I can't wait for the Knuckles figure to be released, and I can't wait to do Robotnik. Hopefully we can do a Robotnik video tomorrow. I am still a little bit disappointed that they're not 4-inch, because I'd love for the movie 2 figures to be able to mix in with them, and now I'm thinking maybe it was a business decision, because they probably figure everyone already has Sonic, Tails, and Knuckles in the 4-inch scale, so if they made these 5-inch, then it'd be like an excuse for people to rebuy those characters. Very shifty there, Jack Specific. But oh well. All right, let us know what you think down in the comments section, friends. Have a fantastic Tails Tuesday, and toast!